This year, 2013, has been a very interesting year for a lot of people. And when I say interesting, I don't mean it nicely. And it has been more than once when I have said, "What a year." And my God, what a year it has been. I have seen things this year that is like, wow. Amazing. And I don't mean that nicely. And yet, I have seen the weak become strong. And I have seen the strong become weak. I have seen people lose everything. And I have seen those who had lost everything gain everything. What a year. Those high and mighty, one flick, gone. And those who were weak found a strength. Have you found your strength this year? Did you? Or were you the high and mighty that gets swept under the rug? I hope not. I have seen people lose everything. The most dear one, the most precious one. And I have seen the very ones find the love forever, the timeless love. That's what this year has been. Hard for some, transforming for the others. And regardless of whatever, no status quo shall remain. Change, 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 change. There's a couplet from Kabir. The mind has many colors, constantly changing, many twangs, continuously, at night, at day. Sometimes it is doing this, sometimes it is doing that. Sometimes you're thinking this, sometimes you're thinking that, sometimes you want to do this, sometimes you want to do that. Many colors, many twangs. Change, 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 change. But, Kabir says, the one who remains only in that one color, doesn't keep changing, is very rare. Rare. All of us? Can you imagine if the next iPhone or the Samsung Galaxy, the next one, could read minds? You know how much trouble you'd be in? All the colors keep changing, and you keep changing colors, and now what do you look like? A chameleon. But there is a color, the color of peace, the color of joy, the color of surety, the color that understands that this breath is the most profound gift that I could be given. How many of you have thought at times that you are the most unfortunate person on the face of this earth? Come on. How many of you have thought, why does this only happen to me? Is it my stars? Why me? Wow. Heavy stuff. I tell you this from my experience, my friends. That is the time to remember how fortunate you are. That is the time to remember. I want to be only in one color. I don't want to keep changing these colors. That is the time to remember how important my happiness is to me. That is the time to remember how each breath that comes into me is the most divine blessing. Stay with your color of clarity. Stay with your color of understanding. Stay with your color of that reality. Stay with that color of that beautiful, profound thing that is inside of you. And you will be the evergreen, that does not change its colors. One of the interviews that I did in Sao Paulo was amazing. I mean, this guy, he actually is in charge. He's the president of a huge area of cable channels. And one of the cable stations that he's also affiliated with is in Guarulhos. So that's where the main international airport is in Sao Paulo. And he had a very good friend. And he was a professor. And the professor was also affiliated with that cable station. And one day, the professor got the bad news that he had cancer and it was not curable. So he was just watching the cable and I came on and he started watching. And it has such a profound impact on him that he called up this guy and he said, who was that guy? It was on the channel. So the guy told him that was Prem Rawat, Birds of Peace. Actually, they don't call me Prem Rawat there, they call me Mr. Prem. So that was Mr. Prem, and he talks about peace and so on. And he said, could you please send me everything you have? So this guy said, of course. And so he made copies of all the materials that he had for the broadcast, sent it to him, and he started watching. And not only he started watching, but his whole family started watching. And then he passed away. Not because he was watching, but he passed away from cancer. And his wife came to this guy and said, thank you so much. Because when he started watching, it completely changed from being in completely non-accepting. He accepted it. He started enjoying his life. It became simpler for him. And not only that, but it became very beautiful for the whole family. And it was very difficult for them. And then they would all sit down and they would watch together. And it completely changed the whole equation, that it made the whole process of him moving on very peaceful for not only him, but his whole family. So, I mean, when he was telling me the story, he had tears in his eyes and everything. And he was just like blown away. And he realized how important then this message was. And so he's trying to get him to more and more stations and more cable stations. But he wanted to do the interview because that was the 10 years of the broadcast. And he wanted to show. And so it was really beautiful to just see somebody who's just interested in the message. You know, and this is what is happening in Ecuador. This is what's happening in Cusco. This is what's happening in Ibarra. This is what's happening in Otavalo. One of the meetings that's going to be happening there, in that neck of the woods, or should I say top of the mountains, is going to be actually meeting with gang members who are watching this message and want to change.
Buenas noches, mi nombre es Cristina Recalde. Para mí es un placer tenerte frente, solamente he tenido el placer de verte en videos y todavía no termino de salir del asombro de que estoy haciéndote una pregunta. Como bien es cierto, soy líder de una pandilla y también pertenezco a un grupo de trabajo aquí denominado Calle Paz y Respeto. Es algo impresionante lo que nos ha pasado aquí a mis compañeros y yo. Como dicen los videos, nosotros tenemos nuestro propio ángel. En lo personal ha cambiado mi vida y tratamos de hacer eso con mis compañeros y las personas con quien estamos trabajando en los colegios, dando nuestras charlas vivenciales y haciéndoles saber y ver de que el delinquir, el robar, el drogarse no nos lleva a nada bueno. Hemos tenido casos de ver morir a amigos, hermanos, y queremos que todo eso, en su totalidad, si se puede y se llega a alcanzar, que acabe. Y mi pregunta para ti, Prem, es, ¿cómo tú llevarías el mensaje de paz a los jóvenes que pertenecen a pandillas? Gracias.
What I would like to say to you, again, is very simple. It's very simple. It's, you are a human being. When you got up, I didn't know who you were, but I knew you were a human being. That's who you are. Learn to respect yourself. Respect does not mean good manners. You know, open the door for the lady, say thank you, say please. That's just good manners. Respect. Respect yourself. I am a human being. When I talk to human beings, like me, like them, my message comes through loud and clear. And people listen. Even by accident, they listen. Because it is really not coming. I am not here as I know something more than you do. It's not true. It's not about that. You see, even when you were robbing people, you knew one thing. If somebody robbed you, you didn't like it. When somebody stole something of yours, like, you know, stole your earring or something, and where is that? So you knew it, but it's like you were somehow different than the people you were robbing. But you're a human being. Do you know that the breath that comes into you is the same breath that comes into me? The breath says, okay, I'm coming into you, not going, you've been bad, so, okay, time out. No. No. To become beautiful from inside, to become strong from inside. If you want to be wealthy, then learn to be generous. If you want to be strong, then learn humility. If you want to be smart, learn simplicity. That's what it takes. Learn simplicity. Learn humility. If you want that strength, learn that gentleness towards yourself. A candle has one thing that it can do, and that is it can light other candles. All you have to be is the candle that lights the unlit candles. It's better than robbing them. Because, you know, either way, they will remember you. But one way, they will remember you with fear, and the other way, they will remember you with gratitude. You want to be famous? Light the unlit candle. That's what it takes. If I talk to a gang member, I don't know what to say to them. I really don't. I talk to human beings, I could talk to you all day long. All day long. And that's why I'm talking to you. Otherwise, I would have easily said, Celine, please pass down. This is your question now. You answer it. Or Richard, you answer it. You're smarter than me. You answer it. But, you know, to a human being, I can talk. It's true. Have I done things that are wrong? Of course I have. But I learned from my mistakes. There is a saying, if you're down there, pick something up. You're down there anyways, find something to pick up, you know. So, and then then comes this hopelessness. Oh yeah, but you know, there's no hope for me. Why not? Why not? The breath isn't giving up hope on you. Why are you giving up hope on yourself? Who can you be? Who can you be? You can be anything you want to be. And if you don't know that, then how did you end up being a gang member? You know, you ended up being a gang member because you could be anybody you wanted to be. You chose that. Can you change your mind? Of course. That's the beauty of it. That's the beauty of it. But this time, be pure of heart. This time, be pure of heart. And that will be your strength. Belong to the gang of the really cool. I just went through a little over a month of training. And when I was going for the training, my ego had preceded me. And it basically went on to say, hey, you know, this is gonna be just a walk in the park for you, because you know you've been flying these airplanes for God, I don't even care to know how many years. You've flown G4s, you've flown G5s, you've flown G550s. What can be so different? So I'm there the first day. I'm impressed because the training begins with, do you know how to work an iPad? Seriously. My ego says this is going to be easier. The training guy says, the instructor says, do you all know how to use, do you have an iPad? Do you know how to use an iPad? And if you don't, there are some iPads that you can use. iPad. I know iPad. Not a problem. Then he goes, okay, we you know, don't have to spend an hour teaching you how to operate an iPad. We're good. And then it begins. And my ego says, Uh-oh. And my ego says, but it's okay. It's okay because this must be just a little bit. Little bit. Then it'll just all get back and everything will be normal. By day two, my smile was gone. I had a definitive ego hunt session where it was like, no, you are wrong. And I realized how different this was. It was like, pay attention. Pay attention. This is different. And that's when I started learning. And actually enjoying. Because it's really neat stuff. It's all technology, so I really like that. Wild. Stuff I didn't ever know. Learned. Enjoyed. How many of you do the same thing for every day that comes in your life? I know this day. That means you're not paying attention. Oh, I know. I've been through this before. What do people say? These hair are not gray for, you know, no reason at all. This, I've got experience. Except look at your experience. You're really experienced as falling flat on your face. Really good at it. You can do it without anybody knowing. You're a master. You have finally achieved perfection at failure. It's not meant to be that way. It is meant to be. You're supposed to be the master of welcoming the new day, the master of paying attention. Don't you want to be the master of paying attention? I mean, how cool does that sound? Master of paying attention. Attention to your life. You know what attention does. When you pay attention to something, you can change things. You know that. You know that. You pay attention to your stupid little car, and the next thing you know, it's shining. You pay attention to your dog, and the next thing you know, that dog is actually just like the cutest thing in the world, and it's just obeying everything you're telling it. I mean, it's like unbelievable. Pay attention to your child and you know what happens. You actually get a child instead of somebody else's kid that happens to know your name and you happen to know his. You pay attention to your friend and you end up with a friend. You pay attention to your salad, and my God, it actually tastes good. You pay attention to your silly little basil plant. And instead of looking like some pathetic God knows what, it's actually flowering. It's really actually got basil in it. Actually, tastes good. You pay attention to your hair. Well, some of you can't, but you pay attention to your hair, and my goodness, the next thing you know, wow. And that's just little things. Can you imagine if you started paying attention to your life? What would happen? To your life? Pay attention to your life. Why so serious? Because we don't. It's the wilted little plant, the basil, is a wilted little thing that looks, you know. Basil is supposed to look like green, and this one looks brown. Pay attention to your day. Pay attention to this breath. Pay attention to this life. Pay attention. Become the master of paying attention. That's your sword, you know. Wherever you point this thing, you will win. That's all it takes. You will win. There is your secret. How do you succeed? Pay attention. One day, this lady, I had known her for quite a few years, lovely person, was. And so she sent me a note saying, I'm going, and I would really love to see you before I go. So I realized that in her condition, she wasn't coming to see me where I was. I will have to go to where she is. So I went to her home. And it was amazing. She was so cheerful. She had to have oxygen. She was tethered to the oxygen. If it wasn't for the oxygen, you wouldn't really know she's going anywhere. You know, the question would be, and where are you going? Are you going on a vacation or something? But I knew. And I started explaining to her, because that was an understanding that I had. What a wrong definition death is. This is going to stay here. It's not going anywhere. I mean, nowhere. It's going to stay here. How long? For billions of years. Not millions, billions of years. It's a fact. I'm not making this up. This is what happens. This stays here. The other thing that's in you is the divine. Right? You think divine can go somewhere? Even if the divine decided tomorrow, I want to go somewhere. I mean, if the divine just pretend was on that side of the stage, not the photographer, just on the stage. He's not on the stage. So this. As the divine was on that side of the stage, and the divine said, you know what, I want to go on that side of the stage. You think the divine can do that? What do you think? Have I stumped you? Divine is the only thing that's there, and here, and here, all the time. This is what I told her. And then she just started laughing and making jokes about how she's going to come back as an eggplant and a tomato, a whole salad. And there's the presence of a person, that combination, the presence of that person. You will, and a lot of people say, well, that's what I'll miss. Then I was talking to somebody whose mother passed away. And this person was, you know, what about this, what about that? And I said, look, and this is something I said, even I liked it. And I said, think of her as the earth and the moon. The moon came from the earth and as it separated, it went out and it's just there. It's not part of the earth anymore, but it's just there. Going around this earth, beautifully affecting it. Every night, every day, making the tides, the life, the motion. All you have to look up and see the reflection of the sun on this beautiful surface, glowing, glowing. For those who go, think of them the same way. Your little world, now they are the moon, and hopefully they're going to affect you in the most beautiful way that you will remember their memory, the tides, the life, the drama, and on those particular nights when it is really dark, they will glow. And there'll be a little light for you, not only to admire, but maybe see why. Living life consciously is about acknowledging those needs that are fundamental to you. When you go out on an outing, what do? You take with you what is important. What is the traveler's dilemma? What is the traveler's dilemma? See, I travel a lot, so I know what that is. It's, should you bring the kitchen sink or not? It's amazing. It's amazing how easy it is to overpack at home. And it is amazing how easy it is to lug that overpacked luggage to your car. It is only when you arrive at your destination do you realize how overpacked you are. I don't know why it is like that. It's like, I don't need that. I don't need that. I don't need that. I don't. Why do I keep bringing them? You know, it's like you need a checklist, not of things you bring, but the things you should never bring. Because you don't need them. We'll never need them. This is just going from one place to another place. I'm talking about the journey of life that comes when we were born and is going to go on till the very last breath in us. The journey is afoot. Have you overpacked? Absolutely. Have you packed the right things? Have you packed the right things? Have you packed the right things? Did you bring on this journey with you with no uncertainty? Did you bring on this journey with no uncertainty? Understanding. With no uncertainty. That every day that you walk the path of your existence, that you walk not in fog, not eyes closed, but eyes wide open. That every day that you exist, you know at any given moment where you want to be inside. That every day that comes to you is not a mistake, but you're fully prepared. Are you fully prepared? Because there's one coming. There's one coming. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you truly, truly ready? And when it comes, is it going to take you by surprise? Or are you so well prepared for it that you will greet it with your arms wide open and a big smile on your face? You know, there's a lot of problems in this world. A lot. I mean, a lot. I mean, really a lot. And that's what you and I do. We solve problems. From morning to evening, we solve problems. I mean, you are, in fact, so involved, so dramatically involved in solving problems that you don't even realize that's what you're doing. But you're doing it. And of all the problems that you have solved, they don't seem to dissipate. There isn't like a number, a fixed number, so that more you solve, the less they will be, and then finally you will get to a certain point in your life and there'll be no more problems. That would be great. So why am I telling you this, right? But this is what happened to me. One day, I was just frantically, I mean, right from the morning, solving problems, yeah, yeah. And I'm good at it. So, yeah, that's it. And then all of a sudden I'm like, is this why I'm alive? To solve problems? Because that day I was so good, I was not only solving my problems, I was solving other people's problems. Is this why I live? Is this why you live? I mean, you have to ask yourself this question. I am not aware that I have created problems whilst I have been trying to solve my problems. So engrossed in solving my problems that I have forgotten to look at the obvious problem, that the time is flying. Faster than I realize. Another day. The strength that that man or woman would carry that only lived for today. Would be unimaginable. The company of that person would be so magnificent who had learned to live. Don't you think so? I would be in awe. I would be in awe. That person who has liberated themselves from the routine of solving problems would have surely learned to live. Live. Exist. Exist. To them, existence wouldn't be some lopsided thing that can be debated. When you begin to live today, today, this is what happens. This is what happens. A whole another world opens. And in this whole another world that opens up, there's life, there's joy. All these words that I'm going to say, they're strung together. They're distinctly on one side. They're strung together. There's clarity. There's bliss. There's understanding. There's kindness. There's contentment. And all that, that through your problem solving, you're trying to remove anguish, fear, anger, pain, suffering. They definitely belong on the other side. You are the source of your agitation. Other people are just catalysts, but you are the source. That's a really good quote. I'll have to remember that one. Other people are just the catalyst. You are the source of your agitation. You are the source of your confusion. And you are the source of your clarity. You are the source of your discontentment, and you are the source of your joy. Find your life. Find your life. Find it. Where? Find it where it is. Not where you think it is, but where it is. And then how can you not be content? Because you lived, you understood what it means to be alive, you accepted, you embraced your existence. You accepted the blessing. In all the years that you have been alive on the face of this earth, have you had one of these days where you get up and you feel really well rested? And you feel good. You just feel good. I mean, just feel good. Not agitated. Just feel good. And you see somebody that you know and you say, "Good morning." And you mean it. I mean, just one of those days. I know it would be rare. But just one of those days, right? It's just, it seems like you feel well, content, full. It's not your birthday. It's not your wedding day. Just a day in your life. And for no reason at all, you just feel good. And your son comes up to you and says, "Dad, I haven't done my homework." And you say, "Ah, okay. It's all right. Do it when you get chance." The coffee tastes good. Life is good. Things are good. Have you ever had one of those days? I mean, even if it was just one. Have you ever had one of those days? So this feeling that you had? Where do you think it came from? You think something they mixed in the tap water? Where did it come from? It came from you. It came from you. You. You are the carrier of this incredible, beautiful thing called peace.